Across our fragile planet, farmers work the land to put food on our tables. In the global south, independent smallholder farmers provide affordable food for their communities, harvesting food from high-welfare animals and sustainable crops. Up to 80% of food in sub-Saharan Africa is produced in this way. Elsewhere, industrial factory farms dominate. Caged animals live in unimaginably cruel conditions and are dosed with drugs to stave off diseases, ensuring the mass production never ends and profits flow. Swaths of wild habitat are destroyed to plant crops for animal feed, and the journey from factory farm to plate pumps more than 6 trillion tons of emissions into the atmosphere annually. From India and Pakistan to Mongolia, in the Amazon and across Africa, food security and social stability are threatened by droughts, floods, wildfires, extreme temperatures, crop failure, and death of livestock. And things are getting worse. Factory farming accounts for 11% of global greenhouse emissions, and by 2050 will cause over $100 billion a year in damage. The devastating effect of factory farms, especially in developing countries, has been difficult to gauge until now. Groundbreaking research by World Animal Protection shows how the livelihoods of smallholder farmers and the communities they serve are being decimated by industrial processes in far-off countries. Instead of expanding industrial farming methods, we can learn from farmers like John Kamathi and his wife Belize. The developed global north needs to farm responsibly. We must transition to humane and sustainable food production. Eat less meat and more plant-based foods. We must end factory farming. Because there is a cleaner, fairer, cruelty-free way to feed the world.